Welcome to Love Fellowship Believers. We're glad that you're here. We want you to experience what it is God is doing for us and with us here at our church. We're located at 3309 Burlington Road. We're loving what the Lord is doing with us, and we invite you to come out and experience what it is God is doing. Now join us already in service.
Let's stand. The Word of God is Nehemiah, the sixth chapter. Amen. Nehemiah, the sixth chapter. Hallelujah. Great thing I love about people is that God really, really has some nice people. They just got to take the mask off and the shells off and be you. Sixth chapter of Nehemiah. To the brothers who was here early, to the early service, the communion, God bless you. Nehemiah, the sixth chapter. Verse number 8 and 9. I'll be reading from the International Children's Edition. And our babies look so good. And it'll be straight A's in here this year. Amen. It'll be straight A's. It'll be straight A's. Straight A's. I said, thank you. She said, I received that. Amen. I mean, get off of MySpace and Facebook. Only book you need to have your face in is algebra. I need to do that commercial. Get your face out of that book and get your face in the book. Continue to have those in prayer that are visiting the hospital for healing and deliverance. I'm reading from the International Children's Edition. Sort of read a little different, Pastor. Verse number 8. The Bible says these words, Nehemiah 6 and 8. So I sent him back this answer. Nothing. Somebody say nothing.
Nothing.
That's half of y'all. Somebody say nothing.
Nothing.
3/4 of y'all. Somebody say nothing.
Nothing.
Nothing you are saying is really happening. You're just making it up in your own mind. Our enemies were just trying to scare us. They were thinking they could get us too weak to work. Then the wall will not be finished. I want to stop right there and says they were thinking they would get us too weak to work. Then the wall would not be finished. Look at somebody, say neighbor. That's the wrong answer. It's my time now. Come on, shake somebody's hand, say wrong answer. It's my time now. God bless you. Take your seats. Somebody say wrong answer. Kobe Bryant walked off the court in 2008 at the NBA Finals, the last game, 7, with his head down after the Boston Celtics spanked his team by 30-plus points. Kobe's head was bent over. His eyes were watery. As he walked off the court, Kobe said to the reporters, "This is one of the worst days of my life." Kobe felt the devastation blow that had hit him and his team, that everything he had worked for all year had now been lost in one game. Yet fate would have it so that Kobe would find himself in that same position 2 years later, against the same team, the Boston Celtics, in the last game of the 2010 finals, only to declare this time he's a winner. And Kobe's Lakers, of course, won in spite of Kobe's dismal game. His non-spectacular performance still overrode and overridden the game itself. Kobe, yes, became the MVP of the finals, and his team won this year's trophy. And I give a shout out, because I am a Laker, to all the Lakers in the building. Oh, don't hate, congratulate, because we on top. But at that moment, as I was reminiscing, as Mary J. Blige said in the 90s, that God spoke to me last night and said, what did Kobe say in the interview this time? Kobe said that, well, I was not having a good night because I wanted it so bad that I was willing to do whatever it took for me to win. And the commentator said that not only were you doing it well, Kobe, but your focus was spectacular. Because at one and a half time, at one timeout, excuse me, comedian actor Chris Rock happened to be two seats from you, Kobe, and he was trying with all of his funny man tactics to take your mind off of the game. Chris Rock was trying with all his power to shake you and break you. He was trying to take your attention off of what you were doing. He said, and the whole world saw, you paid him no attention. Kobe said, man, if you was with me 2 years ago and you had to go home to my house and deal with the pain and deal with the struggle to know that I got this close to a win and it got out of my grasp. If you knew that that night I had to kiss my wife and my little girls and go in my secret room and cry all night, if you knew how I felt after that loss, then you would understand how determined I am to win. Because after that night, the next day I went out and I watched film from that loss. The next day I went out, while everybody else was chilling, taking time off, I was looking at the mistakes we made as a team. And I asked myself, if I ever get myself in that situation again, I promise I was not going to lose. I made sure that nothing would break my focus. I need to stop for station identification and put 10 cents in this meter and ask, is there anybody up in this place who make it up in your mind, God, if you ever put me back in a situation where I can win again, I promise you this time I won't lose my focus. If you ever could, God, Johnny come lately, put the blessing in front of me, I promise you I won't fail you again. Oh, I need about one more other person to throw your hands up and say, God, because I remember all the losses I had in my life, and if my neighbor knew all the pains I had to go through, if my neighbor knew all the sleepless nights I had to deal with, if my neighbor knew all the stuff that I had to cry about, if my neighbor knew I didn't have enough money, if my neighbor knew I had to stand at the bus stop, if my neighbor knew I had to make the babies by myself, if my neighbor knew my tears and my pain and my heartaches, then they would understand my passion for winning right now. Touch your neighbor, say, neighbor, you don't know my story. Because if you knew my story, glory, you would understand that I don't come to church to look at everybody. I don't come to church to make friends with nobody. I don't come to church to worry about what they're going to sing and what they got on. I don't come to church to worry about how they're going to dance and who don't like me. Ain't nobody going to break my focus. Can I get one person up in this place that will throw your hands up right now and say, ain't nobody going to break my focus? If you knew the stuff I had to come out of just to get back in the where I am, I'm too close to let somebody lose it right now. I don't care how funny and how crazy you think you're acting. Look at somebody, say, I'm too close now. You done lost your mind. Y'all ain't helping me. Look at your neighbor, say, I'm too close now. Now ain't the time for games. Now ain't the time to be texting. Now ain't the time to be scuba diving and taking a vacation. Our children are killing each other. Our women are acting out here selling their bodies. Men are going to jail in hand baskets. People are killing each other for no reason at all. We need to be on our faces. We ain't got time for playing games. We ain't got time for lollipops. We ain't got time for Willy Wonka members. I need somebody up in this place. Throw your hands up, say, it ain't a game. It's real life. My life is on the line. And if God ever puts a blessing in front of me again, I promise you this time, I'm not going to lose. Touch your neighbor, say, I done made it up in my mind. I done studied my film. I know what a chicken head looked like. I know what a Jezebel looked like. I know what a demon looked like. You ain't got to ask me to spend time with them. I done lost time with them. Somebody open your mind. Say, I ain't losing no more time to somebody that's talking out of two sides of their mouth. You can play all you get ready, but my God is for real. Somebody open your mouth and say, for real. I ain't here playing with Lottie Dottie and everybody. I'm in a fight for my life. Kobe said, you thinking he can shake me? He done lost his mind. I'm too focused now. Somebody say, I'm too blessed. I'm too blessed to have my head down. I'm too anointed to be worrying about who don't like me. I'm too, y'all ain't saying nothing. I got too much inside of me to worry about my failures and my shortcomings. Yes, I need a witness. Touch somebody, say yes. Y'all ain't helping me, say yes. Yes, I lost before. I lost time with some folk that wasn't even worth my time. I lost some money with some folk that wasn't but liars, witches, and bells. Yeah, I went to hell. Y'all ain't saying nothing. And I put up with some hell from some people. But I done made it up in my mind that if God ever get me back together again, I won't lose again. Shake somebody's hand. Say, I left that church. I left that ministry. I left that man. I left that woman. Say, I ain't losing no more time now. Oh God, please, can I get 6 minutes? I feel my leg moving now. Somebody say, I'm too blessed to lose again. This time, somebody say, this time I'm ready. I need somebody young, say, I'm young and I'm ready. Oh God, y'all ain't gonna help me on my side. I'm young, but I'm ready. Yeah, I might not be perfect, but I'm trying. Yeah, y'all didn't catch that. I can't cross every T and dot every I, but I'm still here. Yeah, baby, yeah. Yeah, I got the bruise. I got the birthmark. Yeah, I got the knot on my head. Yeah, I'm living by myself. But if God be for me, oh my God, I feel it. Who can be against me? Somebody say, I'm on my way. I'm on my way. I'm ready now. Tell somebody, say, I'm ready now. I'm expecting God right now. Matter of fact, this is my season. Y'all, oh my God, did y'all hear what I said? I feel my bow tie coming off now. Somebody say, this my season. Warren Buffett, who is Bill Gates' main man, Warren Buffett says, do not invest while everybody else is investing. invest when nobody else ain't investing. Oh yeah, y'all didn't catch what I said. While everybody else is looking for doom and gloom, I'm looking for breakthrough and increase. Y'all ain't got to help me right here. While everybody looking to struggle and make ends meet, I'm looking for the overflow of God. Yeah, Jacob, how you looking for it? Because I've been faithful. Y'all ain't saying nothing in my lion's den. I've been faithful when folk was unfaithful to me. Yeah, Lord. And now it's my time. Your neighbor ain't got to get it, but somebody say, it's my time. Your neighbor ain't even got to get with you. But your neighbor don't know you already been through all the requirements to get your blessing. Count it all joy when you go through. You need to shout not on where you are. You need to shout on the stuff you came out of. Look at your neighbor and say, don't shout because of what I got. You need to shout because of the hell I came out of. If your neighbor knew all the stuff that God pulled you out of, they'll be praising God for you right now. But open your mouth, say, I done come a long way. Excuse me. I'm sorry, y'all. I feel like misbehaving. But look at somebody say, my time now. Yeah, my time. My time to get back everything that the devil has stolen. Somebody say, everything. No. I want it all back. No, I want it all. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I know that sounds a little selfish, but somebody say it all back. I want it all back. Everything that's been messed up in my life, I want God to fix it. Somebody say, fix it, Jesus. I want everything. I want my attitude back. Yeah, some of y'all ladies done lost your swag because you done fooled with a no good brother. Forget that brother. It's another brother out here. Some of y'all brothers fooling with them old silly sisters. Forget that sister. She ain't that cute. There's another sister out here. Some of y'all quiet now. Y'all better open your mouth and say, get your swag back. Walk around here looking like Aunt Jemima. Ain't nobody gonna buy no Aunt Jemima looking woman. Get your hair on your head. If you ain't got no hair, buy some weave. Abby's open and the wig shop is too. Open your mouth and say, I'm getting my anointing back. I'm getting my joy back. If I got to go to the beach by myself, lay my big butt on the water and grease myself down and say, this is the day. Say, neighbor, if nobody encourage you, encourage yourself. When I think of the goodness, can I get somebody say, yeah, of Jesus at all? I got to stop. Somebody say, I'm getting myself together. Nehemiah, somebody say Nehemiah. Nehemiah was the cupbearer to the king. Somebody say, I've been serving long enough. Y'all didn't hear that. I said Nehemiah was a servant to the king. I'm going to slow it down and bring it back the old school way. Put it in 30 speed motion, short bus. Nehemiah was a servant to the king. Can I speak something for about three of y'all who ready for it? You've been serving, but they getting ready to serve you. Can I serve you up? Y'all ain't gonna help me. You've been helping everybody else, but God say, now is your time to flip the script. Can I prophesy to three people? You've been working for somebody, but at the end of this year, they gonna work for you. I'm sorry, let me get back in my position. I know how to act. I got two masters and a doctorate. I might well be dignified. He was a servant to the king who had a dangerous job. God bless you, sir. He had a dangerous, say dangerous job. No, notice what his job was, y'all. And Nehemiah was the one who would test the food or the drink to make sure it wasn't no poisons in it. What kind of job is this? Because back then, the only way to get rid of a king is for he had to croak over and die, or somebody had to poison him. You couldn't just exile him. You was a king till you died. Y'all ain't, wasn't no vote like Obama. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Care nothing about them lying Florida votes. It wasn't none of that. When you was the king,
You was the king until you were dead. So if folk had problems with the king, they would give them some food like they do pastors. And Pastor Webb, don't let me say something to you, young man. Don't eat everybody's food that come to church. You know, we too close to North Carolina. You know, they have chicken feet and roots, and they be coming to church and pastor be preaching and scratching. Y'all, I know, come on. I know, yeah, some of them women put some stuff on you. You be outside with some church socks and some underwear for no reason at all. Talking about you coming to church, pastor, it's Thursday. Oh, I'm sorry. You can't eat everybody's food. I need somebody to say can't eat everybody's food. Because everybody don't mean well for you. Be done had diarrhea for a month. Hallelujah. So Nehemiah, notice what he did. If anybody wanted to kill the king, they would feed him. Because it was everybody, they don't want to hear this, this is for the pastor, everybody's responsibility to bless the king. Okay, y'all didn't hear that. That means the king ate food from folk that didn't like him. Yeah, y'all ain't saying nothing. Yeah, as a pastor, I got to feed you even if I don't like you. Oh, you see, only them coke churches is praise God for folk and give them money. But up in here, I got to love everybody. Whether you like me or not, I got to give it to you. So Nehemiah would be the guinea pig. And he would drink the drink, and the king would watch him. About 30 minutes to digest and see if he fall out. If he get up and run, bring me the food now. What a job. A job that didn't know if the next meal you took would take you out. But it was Nehemiah's job to be trustworthy, because if Nehemiah had a problem with the king, he could have act like it was good. And act like he swallowed it, but didn't, to get rid of the king. That's why you got to be careful that everybody that bring you stuff, you know them. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Because the devil positions himself close to preachers and close to ushers. And y'all ain't saying nothing. The devil ain't no dummy, you know. No, he'll make some good food to keep you at that table. So not only is all food not bad for you, some food that's good you don't need to eat that much of. Yeah, some tables you need to say push away. But Nehemiah was found trustworthy and got wind of what was happening in ruins, the walls, which is the city of God messed up. So what he did, listen what the Bible said, he cried for 4 months. Somebody say, it's my time now. Look at your neighbor and say, but I ain't crying no more. Yeah, he cried, the Hebrew calendar, the month of Nisan, which is April. He started crying in Kelsed, which is the month of December. When he found out that the people of God was going through, when he heard that the people of God was being dogged out and heard they were being killed at the stakes and heard that the little children were being sold into slavery, when he heard that the house of God was laid in ruins, the Bible said he cried from Christmas to Easter. Lord, have mercy, Jesus. This man had a heart for the people of God. And after he got through crying those 4 months, he waited for the right time to go and request from the king. Oh, king, now is my time now to go home and rebuild the place where my fathers are buried. See, you got to be wise, because God ain't never gonna give you a project when it's all about you. Y'all didn't shout right there. I knew I wasn't gonna get no help from that side. Whenever God gives somebody a rebuilding process, the process cannot be pointed at you. At the end of the day, you might bless the pastor with money, you might bless the church with money, but at the end of the day, it's to God be the glory. Because if you're giving it for man, you're giving it for the wrong reason. God says this man moved the king's heart because he was worried about the reputation of his father. And one of the worst things we could see now in the church is nobody appreciating the history of the church. Oh, y'all ain't got to like me right here. Somebody helped you get saved.
saved. Somebody brought you to the altar. Somebody spent some money on Sunday school. Somebody put some time behind your anointing. And what you should do is never forget. Had it not been for your forefathers who spoke life into you, you wouldn't be who you are today. Because of this movement of Nehemiah, the king said, I will bless you, son. Since it's your time, what I got to do is, first of all, redeem the time. Touch your neighbor, say, let's work backwards. I feel God making 40 look 20. Y'all ain't saying nothing. And 60 look 30. Y'all didn't catch it. I feel God making someone that's 50 look like they 25. And you getting hit on by little boys and you saying, I could be your mama. But you say, you know, it's something about how God makes you look good. And folk think you younger than you are. You just gonna say, that's called living right. It ain't in the water, baby. It's in the genes. My father is rich. Y'all ain't saying nothing. When God is on your side, the first thing he's gonna do, he's gonna give you sufficient time to work out what you got to get worked out. The Bible said he asked the king, oh king, give me time to go rebuild my life. Can I prophesy to three people? It ain't but a matter of time for you get back everything that the enemy stole. Okay, excuse me. For some of y'all, it's going to be 1 year. That's too long. For some of y'all, it's going to be 6 months. That's too long. But for Love Fellowship, by this time next month, you'll be in your new place. Somebody need to shout right now. Say, that's too long. I'm believing God right now that before you go get back in your car and make it back here to the evening service, God will redeem time and add on years that the enemy has stolen. He asked the king, oh king, I need some time. The king said, Nebuchadnezzar, you've always been good. Excuse me, Nehemiah. You've always been good to me. So what I'm going to do is give you 12 years. Can I get somebody to say, thank you, Jesus? Can any of y'all think about some years you lost to some buzzards? Some years you gave to people that you wish you can get back? I dare you to praise God for 3 seconds. And God say, I'll add years that the enemy has stolen. Yeah, you lost time, but I'll give you back. Tell somebody, say, just time. Yeah, all I need is a little time. Look at somebody, say, by this time next year, you will see what I'm praising God for. You don't know why I'm praising God and I'm at the bus stop. You don't know why I'm praising God single. Because by this time, I'll be married next year. By this time, I won't be catching the bus. I'll be riding a bus. My bus. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Yeah, yeah. All I need is some time. Say time. Then he asked the king. He said, oh, king, since I'm going to pass through some lands where people don't know me, what I need you to do is pardon me with some papers. I need somebody to go get your papers. Say, neighbor, get your visa. Because God getting ready to bring you to the Bahamas, baby. Get your visa. God getting ready to bring you to Jamaica, man. Get, y'all ain't saying nothing to me. I need some of y'all to go get a visa. And they gonna say, what you getting a visa and you ain't got a car? You say, cause I'm expecting God to make me all Caribbean. I need somebody to say, I ain't dying like this. Carowinds ain't gonna be a vacation. Hawaii gonna be a vacation. And if you don't wanna go, I'll go and get the bus ticket and get the plane ticket. Buy my. Oh God. So he says, king, give me secure and safe travels. So what the king does, notice what the king does. See, when you praise God, God gonna give you favor with the king. Now let me pause here for 3 seconds. Nehemiah ain't pulled out no money yet. And God done gave him time and gave him papers. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I need some people to stop preaching about money and preach about praise. If you praise God, God will give you favor with somebody who got the money and got the... Y'all ain't saying nothing. Shout for 3 seconds, even if you ain't got it. Because God got everything you... I feel like... Look at your name and say, God got everything. If you need something, don't call Duke Power. Don't call the sugar daddy. Drop back your head and call Jesus. He may not come when you want him, but
safe travel. So the king says, well, what I'm gonna do for you is hook you up, bruh. I'm gonna give you some papers. Watch this. Because everybody don't know you've been faithful to me. Listen. Everybody don't know in Asia Minor. Everybody don't know in Ethiopia. Everybody don't know how you've been to me. So what I'm gonna do is give you some papers from me. So everywhere you go, people gonna recognize me. And if they recognize me that I stamped you, they gonna let you be free. Y'all didn't catch what I said. For somebody, I'm gonna slow it down. You'll catch it tomorrow. God says, for y'all, everywhere you go, folk might not know you. But if you come in my name, you're gonna get papers granted to go into your new season. I need to prophesy to somebody and say, nobody ain't gonna know your worship in outside of here. But if God put his name on here, everywhere you go, God gonna go with you. Access granted, 106 in Park. He says, I'm gonna put my name on it. Now watch this. He says, because you're gonna pass through, watch this. But when you get to where you're going to start rebuild, they still ain't gonna give you no power. So what I'm getting ready to do is elevate your office. Somebody say, it's my time now. No, say it again. Come on, I feel I'd be healed. I'm gonna make you say it again. By God, say it again. If you can't say it, you don't, but say it's my time now. He says, you've been serving me. Not knowing if you're going to die every time you did it. If you ain't got no members that are willing to die for the gospel, you ain't got nobody that's got saved. If you ask your members for anything and they say no, they ain't your members. Y'all ain't got to help me. Because my mama's right here. Anything I need and she knows I need it for survival, she'll do it. And before anybody gets to me, they got to go through her. Y'all ain't saying nothing. So what Jesus says is, you're going to be there, but I got to elevate you so people can respect your office. So he says, no longer are you my cupbearer, but now you a governor. Watch this. You are a governor, well, Lockett, of Judah. That's for one person who understands what Judah is. Judah is praise. Oh, God. Jacob, what are you saying? God ain't never going to make someone who ain't a praiser over nothing. Okay, yeah. If there's somebody want to usher and can't shout every now and then, they don't need to usher. If somebody want to sing and can't forget who they singing to, they don't need to sing. I need somebody to say, I'm a praiser first. You need to get the hell raisers out the church and get the praisers in the church. Because it ain't about how much you know. It's about how much praise can you get. Anybody can praise them when you got stuff. Touch your neighbor and say, can you praise them when you ain't got nothing? Okay, y'all missed it. God is going to promote praisers. Touch your neighbor and say, why are you still quiet then? If you need a promotion, your mouth ought to stay on automatic. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Pause for a Gatorade break. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Give me some Red Bull. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Give me some coffee. When I think of the goodness of Jesus. And open your mouth. Say, this ain't about you. I need a promotion. I need promotion. Well, if you need promotion, give him a praise. Sit down. We got 5 minutes and we got to go. Touch somebody. Say, I am a praiser. So he says, go with the papers, and when you get to Judah, tell the governor that's already there then he got to move. Y'all ain't saying nothing. You want to say something? My good God, son, I can't wait to start preaching tag team with. Watch this, first lady, because you can holler like Takeda. What? When, somebody say when. When someone is occupying a position and they let down on their praise and they think they done arrived and they think they all that and you think we can't have church without you and you think you the best thing since sliced bread and you are cooking with the milk and everything else. When you think you don't deserve to give God praise, he sends your replacement. Somebody don't know that God is replacing you right now. And I need somebody to say, God replacing the person that was hating on me. Don't know they got a ticket tomorrow and it's called a pink ticket. You replaced. Donald Trump say, you fired. Because God ain't going to keep nobody around. Okay, y'all don't believe me. His name was Hallel. Lucifer. The devil. The devil was with God. They were tight. Everything in him was a pipe organ. The Bible said his lungs was instruments. Y'all ain't gonna help me. That meant him and God had it going on. Until one day, the devil thought that he was just as powerful as God. So God said, I done made you over the music. I made you over the choir. I made you over the angels. I made you over that. But now you tripping. Here's what I got to let you know. You are expendable. So he reached in heaven, grabbed something, they grabbed something else, grabbed the cloud and kicked him, and he befell as lightning. And his name changed. I want to speak to somebody. Just because you got power and you are anointed and you got all that don't mean you're going to stay there. Because God don't need you that bad. He created you and he'll get rid of you. Care how good I am, next level, I'll fall dead now and it'll keep on going. Yes, nobody gonna stop me. Nobody. We'll cry and keep going. Yes, sir. Funerals don't last nothing longer than the chicken stay cold. Yes, and you go home. Praise. He positions praise. Y'all catch it tomorrow, a little slow. He positions praise. Watch this. Judah was between strife. Watch this. If you have a praiser in your ministry, and you got some people that's a little worrying about positions, running mouth. Everybody got them. You know, we might have one or two today. They've been complaining about how long they're going to get down here. They hungry. It's hot. You know, when we going to go back. I'm all that. Here's what you do. You put a praiser in the middle of them. Because if you get two negative people beside each other, you got trouble. Tell your neighbor, I'm about to bust this click up. Worst thing about starting a ministry is folk might get in little boxes. And every now and then, you got to get somebody in the box and say anything about neither one of y'all. Amen. Don't worry about who sing. I don't care who sing. Long as somebody sing that's anointed. I don't care if anybody play. I can praise God. We don't need a building to praise him. About what your title is. Let me hear your praise. Don't care how cute you are. If you got a stanky attitude, nobody don't want to beat your stanky leg. He puts them between strife and then he asks one thing. He says, King, thank you for the time I got. Thank you for the papers. Thank you for making me governor. However, I still need some stuff. Somebody say, it's my time now. Everything Nehemiah needed, the king released. He got time. He got papers. He got a position. Now he got some money. He said, cut down all the timbers you need to rebuild. Can I speak to somebody? Why you praising God here? God got somebody that got the money you need. That got the stuff you need. Now notice, Nehemiah still ain't gave no money. Serving God has benefits. Why you up in church that high, giving that money, following this man around the country, getting up early in the morning? Because when I leave here, y'all didn't catch what I just said. I said, when I leave here, God is giving me a promotion on my job. God is healing my kids. God is giving me increase. When you do it to God, God reaches out of here
He gave him timbers, and he went to rebuild the wall. And the Bible said that the enemies, when they heard that he was rebuilding his life, rebuilding, they got upset. The sad thing about church folk is nobody gets mad when the bathroom is dirty, but nobody wants to clean it. Nobody gets mad when somebody's going through, but you mad when you bless somebody. Y'all ain't saying, nobody ain't mad how poor the preacher is and how raggedy the church is, but they get mad how rich it is and how beautiful it is. Oh, y'all ain't got to say nothing. Nobody wants to talk about somebody trying to live right, but you'll talk about all the stuff folk been doing. How many babies she got? She smell like weed. Who is he? It doesn't matter who we are. We all trying to be better. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm here. Good God from Zion. I didn't have to come, but I'm here. When you are a worshiper, when you really see God, God gives you a vision for somebody else. Can I say that again? I'm coming home. Can I say it again? When you are a worshiper, God never ever shows to help your raggedy self first. When you really see God, you see others. We ain't about calling my name. Ain't nobody gonna call your name. It's about others. Nehemiah confessed. Listen what he said. He said, we messed up. Now, Nehemiah was not there, but he made confessions for others. I need somebody in here learning how to cover somebody else's sin. Well, y'all didn't see y'all. See, y'all so self, because see, some of y'all so self-righteous where you think that you getting yourself together. I don't come to church to get myself together. I'm a doctor. I come to work on you, and I come to work on you. Is there anybody up in this place on your road? Say, if you touch me, I'll heal your body. I didn't come here to get my praise on. I come here to help you lift you up. I come to help care take. Y'all ain't saying nothing. He confessed to God. God, we messed up. He made a commitment. He said, God, I commit myself to rebuild this wall. He said, I'm concerned about the people being in ruins. He said, will you do one thing? Give me your power. Give me your wisdom and your might. God said, yes. He said, what to do? He said, when the enemies come, here's what you got to do. Don't pay them no attention. Now, y'all, that's elementary. I should have got deep.